All right, Gemini, welcome to your weekly forecast. This is for November 27th through the 3rd of December 2017. And this video is for Sidereal Astrology. If you are new to the channel, definitely check out the link down below. We're using the actual size of the constellations, which does change the signs from mainstream astrology. All right, so this week, let's have a look. We have a lot going on astrologically, actually. Very important events, most of them concentrated over this weekend of this week. And the general gist is that of approaching a full moon. We will have a full moon on Sunday, joining up with a Mercury retrograde, your ruler, you, going through this reconsideration for these next few weeks. And the status check is always a good time to do a reevaluation anyways of matters. So let's break this down here. Looking at Monday, Tuesday, we will have your ruler over Saturn. And this will get revisited next week as well after the retrograde. But this whole new chapter, I think, about really taking some things seriously. Not that you may or may not, but maybe more seriously. And not in a dense way either. Just kind of seeing where you can bring in some responsibility in your life, or maybe some discipline in your life. And this could likely have to do with either your work and routine or relationships. This conjunction will be right on the cusp between your sixth and your seventh house. And it might be a little bit of both for most of you, actually. And I would also say, too, if there is anything that you can establish with your work, your routine, relationships, and maybe even also your home in some way, your foundations, you know, those types of matters, I think it's just an excellent time to be starting that here at the beginning of the week. So once we get to about midweek here, Wednesday, or actually be more like Thursday, Friday, Mars is going to be opposite up to Uranus. So this is a collectively uneasy energy typically where we're wanting to break free. Maybe there's some erratic energy, some nervous energy, and all in all, it could feel like just a bit of like chaos, like things are just not settling or they're just kind of all over the place. So this could have to do with your work and routine, it's possible, and anything involving friends or group stuff. And that whole, and really where this is all taking place though is again with the home sort of situation. You've had a lot of emphasis here these past couple months of putting some energy and action into your home sector. Whatever that might mean for you. And so I think if you are feeling any of that erratic Uranus energy, I think it's all about balance with this opposition. Balance with, you know, maybe getting your roots established, your home established, family, but balancing that with probably wanting to break free with something regarding your career or your work. So seeing, of course, that we need both, right? We need the foundations as well as the future productivity. We need home as well as career. And I think finding that balance will be, I think, helpful. And if you are feeling like you want to make some changes with your work, with your routine, or maybe with your groups or friends sector, you know, good to implement some change, maybe just in a grounded and healthy way, whatever that might mean for you personally. All right, then once we get into the weekend, yes, we'll start to feel a lot of this other energy. The full moon will be very strong. One thing I do want to say, though, is that this whole second half of the week and into next week, Jupiter is going to be trining up to Neptune. So this is a very supportive aspect, and it's going to be taking us all the way into August of 2018. So, you know, the next roughly 9 months. And so there is this very idealistic, very healthy idealism for all of us collectively. And for you, this is about your future. It's about possibilities and potentials. And that open mind that I think Neptune's been helping you develop for like the past 10 years of seeing potentials, it's anchoring you. It's actually grounding you with these roots, maybe matters pertaining to home. And then also supporting you with your self-expression. A lot of you are going to find that, I think, moving into next week, actually, we'll probably start to see some of these opportunities to have some fun, express yourself, get into that creative energy as Jupiter starts to make his way into your fifth house of Libra. So really good for that, for those areas with this trine. I think just all in all, having that sense of hopefulness and inspiration as a backdrop will be the case. Now, Mercury retrograde, right? He's actually technically going to be in your seventh house when he goes retrograde. So reconsideration maybe about relationships, one-to-one connections, and that might just be brief. I think what's really going to be the re-examination for the coming few weeks is going to be on your work and your routine. Maybe there's some things to rehash, rethink, redo involving this area of your life, And so a willingness to do that, I think, can be fantastic. And again, Mercury does rule that fourth house of home for you. So anytime Mercury goes retrograde, it's a great time to reevaluate your home, the past, your personal life, and just generally things in your life. Good to, anytime your ruler goes retrograde, good to kind of take a step back and reexamine some things in general. So the full moon will be in a very spiritual house for you. It will be in the 12th. So in this case, this soul, not reexamination, but this sort of insight you could be gaining right now is pertaining to getting some rest in your life or some more peace in your life. And, you know, all in all, doing that, but through the process of acceptance, right? Acceptance of where you are in the now moment. And with these squares up to Neptune, because Neptune will be squaring up to this full moon, it's going to be collectively spiritual anyways for everybody. It's going to be this time of integrating spirituality, integrating this peace. So anything you can do to challenge yourself with this, I think is fantastic. Like I said, there is this support where you're seeing the potentials for the future with the ninth house and possibilities, but anchoring it, grounding it, you know, in spiritual activities, meditation, whatever, really good to work on and challenge yourself with this. So essentially you can have more peace in your life and really balance that out with your routine. Because like I said, your routine is really going to be emphasized. In fact, it has been emphasized since last week. The sun has recently shifted into here. And so, yeah, this is already actualized. And with the 12th, it's about bringing in some peace into that routine, into that daily sphere, which could be needed. And then Venus shifting in here this weekend as well, helping you see the value, what you enjoy with the day-to-day work and routine also, but developing it nonetheless. And this is something a lot of you have already been doing anyways with Saturn transiting that sixth house. But Saturn is leaving that sixth house here early December. So you're sort of wrapping this up, wrapping all this health or work or day-to-day stuff up for what will be over the next 2 to 3 years, this emphasis on developing your relationships, stability there, groundedness, which will be Saturn in the seventh. All right, Geminis, so have a great week. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you all very soon for the next forecast. Take care.